How old are you?
10.
What grade are you in?
5th.
So thinking like a scientist is good, yeah. Is that right?
Yeah.
So what's bad kind of thinking then?
Thinking like an evil genius.
Okay. How old are you?
12.
What grade are you in?
7th grade.
And what do you think critical thinking is?
A way to decide either things are false, true, or like in the between, using your scientific knowledge.
Mm-hmm. So why do you think it's good that kids learn how to do critical thinking?
Well, maybe if they're religious, then they can get out of that, since they don't have to believe that nonsense that sometimes their adults teach the kids they're born into.
You want to know what I think? How much more time do we have for you after leaving?
I have 9 minutes.
I don't know, but I'm dying to know what you think, Phil.
Here's what I want to do. I want to encourage parents and Christian educators to teach critical thinking skills.
That's it.
That sounds like a good objective.
Do you know why we don't do that?
Because it's hard.
Because we're afraid our kids will actually use them.
And they might come to a different conclusion.
And they might come to a different conclusion that we have come to.
Then, right. Then we're living out of fear.
There's a very interesting article that I tweeted last week about extremes in the homeschooling movement. Mm-hmm. You know, parents, and it's really abusive kind of cases of homeschooling, kids that aren't allowed any outside contact, you know, and homeschooling is just a part of protectionism.
It's like a bunker.
Yeah, basically it's fear-based, you know, you cannot interact with the world because of this fear that you won't accept the beliefs that we want you to accept.
Right.
Okay, that's the opposite of encouraging critical thinking. Now, what's interesting in this article is that some in the homeschooling movement, because of Michael Ferris, who's the head of the Homeschool League and founded Patrick University, he's been, Patrick Henry University, he's been encouraging homeschoolers to learn forensics and debate so that they can debate the world. And so lots of homeschoolers, they've been developed debating homeschool curriculums. And so homeschoolers are debating and kids are learning how to debate. But what's happening that no one foresaw is some of these kids are using their new critical thinking skills to question their parents' beliefs.
Uh-oh.
And parents are becoming very upset.
Don't teach my children to think.
Yes. Yeah. Don't give them that tool if they're going to turn it on me. And that's where our fear...
You know, we can do bad things with stuff other than critical thinking. Should we remove those qualities as well?
Like what?
It's been tried in other monastic communities.
What else can we do?
I'm just going to leave it there.
I see what you're saying.
Yes.
Ethiopian eunuch, anyone?
What to say.
I'm just going down the logical... If we really want to protect our kids from every... Yeah. Bad thing in the world or everything they may choose which is not healthy, then there's all kinds of horrible stuff.
To me, it is the critical issue because every example that Peter Boghossian gives of engaging a conservative Christian in a debate, it is clear the person he is talking to does not know how to think critically because they can't respond.
Right.
And it's not that their beliefs are false, it's that they don't have the facility to answer what is being asked of them.
Maybe we should have him come on our podcast.
Yeah, I don't think he'd want to do that.
We'll put him in a diabetic coma with all the sugar and candy.
I didn't open it. I opened that, okay?
Yeah,
I opened the Shapoopy. That's a song in the Music Man, you know?
No, I did not.
Yeah, Shapoopy.
I don't remember that.
How old are you?
10.
What grade are you in?
5th.
Do you know what critical thinking is?
No.
What do you think it is if you take a guess?
Probably thinking scientifically.
That's a good idea. What does thinking scientifically mean?
Like a scientist.
So thinking like a scientist is good,
yeah.
Is that right?
Yeah.
So what's bad kind of thinking then?
Thinking like an evil genius.
Okay. Do you know what VeggieTales is?
Yeah.
What is VeggieTales?
It's a show for little kids, maybe from like 3 years old to maybe like 7 years old.
And what do they talk about?
Bible stories.
Bible stories,
yeah.
Yes, and silly songs.
Yeah.
It was started by a guy named Phil Vischer, and he says that kids should learn critical thinking. Do you think that's a good idea?
Yeah, it is.
How old are you?
12.
What grade are you in?
7th grade.
So why do you think kids should learn critical thinking skills?
I think they should learn critical thinking skills because, like, so that way they don't always have to believe in that religious stuff that they're born into. They can think for themselves. They don't always have to believe what their parents taught them.
So you think critical thinking will tear apart religious thinking?
Yes.
Why is that?
Because it, once you learn different ways of thinking, instead of just one way of thinking about, like, in religious, once you go into different ways of, different views of the religious part and stuff like that, using critical thinking, like logical fallacies and existentialism, you can probably change your belief.
What's a logical fallacy?
When people say, like, I don't know, therefore God did it. I don't, like, why is there an earthquake? I don't know, therefore God did it. That's a logical fallacy.
What's existentialism?
So, existentialism is, you can believe whatever you want. You can do whatever you want because it's your life. You only live once. YOLO. Yeah, that's it, pretty much. You can do whatever. That's the big part. You can do whatever you want.
So where did you learn that stuff?
My dad, the internet, mainly, that's it. Maybe sometime briefly the teachers will talk about critical thinking. Probably not that much, but it was sometimes in humanities we'll talk about critical thinking.
What do you think about parents who say they should not teach their kids critical thinking because it might make them think things that they don't agree with?
Well, because they don't want to break the tradition in their family, like make them upset, and they really want to keep that tradition because it's, like, gone through their whole family. They really want to keep the tradition with their religion.
So do you think that's a good idea that some parents don't want to teach kids critical thinking?
No. So it's just, like, kind of like saying, like, you don't want your kids to learn.
Mm-hmm.
Like, it's kind of like saying you don't want your kids to go to school, almost, because it's, like, you don't want them to learn about something.